Welcome to this quick guide on precision medicine.
Precision medicine is often defined as an approach to healthcare that takes into account how different each person's environment, lifestyle, and genes are from one another.
Your genes, sometimes called your DNA, are molecules that control how your body makes other molecules, called proteins. Proteins and genes are like puzzle pieces. In cancer, the genes and proteins that make up one person's tumor can be very different from another person's tumor.
As a first step in using precision medicine, your doctor may measure your cancer biomarkers. Biomarkers are molecules in your tumor or your body fluids that can be measured to tell your doctor something specific about your cancer. Biomarkers can be genes, genetic mutations, or proteins. Your doctor may be able to use your biomarker information to guide your treatment options.
The goal of precision medicine is to create a treatment plan according to the precise molecular aspects of each patient's cancer. This makes sure that each person gets the most effective treatment possible. For example, your doctor could decide to use a therapy that specifically targets one of your cancer biomarkers. Targeted therapies act like puzzle pieces, fitting together inside your body with specific genes or proteins. This keeps those genes or proteins from helping your cancer grow.
In addition to helping choose targeted therapies, biomarkers in precision medicine can be used to make a prediction about your risk of developing cancer. To understand the molecular makeup of your cancer and how it changes over time. To judge how well your body would respond to a specific treatment. To look for early signs of how well your body responds to a specific treatment. And to get a sense of how quickly your cancer might grow or spread.
Here's a more specific example. 1 in 5 patients with breast cancer have tumors with high levels of a gene called HER2. High levels of the HER2 gene lead to high levels of the HER2 protein, which helps the cancer grow. These types of tumors are called HER2 positive. Researchers have been working on creating targeted therapies for HER2 positive tumors for more than 20 years. As a result, there are now multiple drugs available that specifically target HER2 positive tumors in different ways. Thanks to these treatments, patients with early HER2 positive breast cancer are far more likely to survive longer. And thanks to biomarker testing, doctors know not to give anti-HER2 therapies to people whose breast cancer is not HER2 positive, since it won't help them.
Precision medicine is sometimes called personalized medicine. This does not mean that treatments are created in a personalized fashion on a patient-by-patient basis, although this does happen in some immunotherapy treatments. What it means is that treatments can be developed for groups of patients whose cancers all share a specific type of gene or protein. This means that our traditional way of thinking about cancer, based on where the cancer is found in the body, is changing. Thanks to precision medicine and biomarker testing, doctors and researchers are beginning to understand that breast cancer or lung cancer, for example, are really many different types of cancer. Each type requires different types of treatments.
A current limitation of precision medicine is that each new targeted therapy tends to benefit only a small group of patients at a time. This is because targeted therapies are made for patients whose cancers share a specific type of gene or protein. While this information is known in some cases, there are many tumor types that researchers have not found targeted therapies for yet.
Doctors and researchers are working all the time to understand which genes and proteins are linked to each patient's particular type of cancer. They are also working to find which treatments will work best against those genes and proteins.
Currently, targeted therapies are only used for some types of cancers. However, research is ongoing and the list is expected to grow. There may not be an improved drug that targets the genes or proteins in your tumor type, but many targeted therapies are now in clinical trials and may be approved in the future. Precision medicine isn't available for all cancer patients yet.
To get a better sense of how precision medicine can work, here's one patient's story. Ide Mills was diagnosed with metastatic lung cancer on Valentine's Day of February 2011. She had her tumor tested for biomarkers and learned that she was ALK positive. At that time, there were no targeted therapies for ALK positive tumors. So instead of precision medicine, I'd started with standard, non-targeted chemotherapy. At the same time, she continued to learn as much information as she could about her disease and her treatment options. Since then, three therapies targeting ALK-positive tumors were approved. Over that time, I'd worked closely with her doctors and used sources of information from CSC to choose the right treatment path for her cancer. I chose to join a clinical trial for a new ALK-targeting drug that worked for her for about a year. When the drug stopped working, she started using a second ALK-targeting therapy.
This example shows how important it is to stay informed throughout your treatment. Precision medicine is changing quickly. New targeted therapies are developed every year.